My favorite thing about being in the research lab is that I actually get to see a lot of really cool stuff every day. Lots of pictures and things that are usually inside of our bodies that we don't get to see on the outside. My name is Jazmine Benjamin. I am a graduate student at the University of Alabama at Birmingham. Growing up, I spent a lot of time by myself, and I was also really curious. I would go outside and, you know, pick up bugs. Looking back now, I think I always had the makings of a scientist. I was always really curious, but also my parents really pushed me to do my own research. And I think that having experiences like that and learning to have a question and figure out the answer for myself before necessarily going and asking someone to give me the answer really led to them fostering that curiosity well into my adult life. Being a Black woman who's also a scientist it's a fun intersection to be at. Parts of my work that give me enjoyment are really getting to talk about my research, especially with the people that it affects. So presenting myself as a scientist to young students in elementary and middle school and just letting them ask me questions. I do a lot of work on high blood pressure, and a lot of the students would say, oh, my grandmother has high blood pressure. And then they would ask me questions about that. So you would see their eyes light up because finally it's something that they can directly relate to, that they can go home and talk to their family about. The value in removing barriers in STEM for diverse individuals, it's immense value in doing that. And I think that we're learning that right now. If I walk into a classroom and someone who doesn't look like me is teaching and I'm only seeing people who don't look like me in the book, I'm not gonna feel like I belong there. I'm not gonna feel like this is a career trajectory that I can take. But if I walk into a room and there is someone who looks like me and sounds like me that's teaching this material, I'm gonna feel more of a personal connection to the material, but I'll also be more likely to interact with the professor, making sure that they, again, see themselves in these STEM fields. And so I think just the visibility is the biggest thing, making sure that Black women are there, that they're front and center. Removing barriers like that will lead to people thinking in different ways. Here's my dad, and this was celebrating my birthday, I believe. Then this is my mom. This was actually taken at my best friend's wedding. My mom is one of my favorite people. I'm a lot like her. She got her master's degree while raising three children and having a job. And so I watched her go to work 8 hours a day, come home, make sure that we all made it to all of our extracurriculars, had dinner, did our homework. And so watching my mom make those sacrifices is always an inspiration to me. I'm gonna try not to cry. And thinking about those that came before me and the sacrifice that they made makes doing what I do worthwhile is really the thing that keeps me going. When I'm not in the research lab, I like to cook. Cooking is a hobby that's really near and dear to me. Cooking is really therapeutic because I like to think of it as very low stakes science. And then of course, hanging out with my dog. Running is another hobby that's very near and dear to me. I have always loved running, even as a child. The advice that I would give to Black girls who are interested in a career like mine is to not be afraid to ask questions and not be afraid to reach out to people who look like you. As far as the future for Black women in STEM, I think there's a ways to go, but I think that a lot of Black women in STEM have been speaking up lately and have been moving into these positions where we're able to enact change. There are a lot more Black women in STEM who are visible now, and I can speak for any of us when I say that we are more than happy to help any Black girl who is interested in STEM. I hope that my future puts me into a career where I'm able to really play to my strengths and advocate for Black women in STEM and really still be able to communicate with the Black community about things that are going on in STEM fields, but also the success of Black women in the field, which will only yield more success for Black women in the field in the future.